Hello, I'm Kelly Swoop with this WMER2 News update. Governor Larry Hogan wants to see more work done to stop the violent crime in Baltimore. Wednesday night, he rolled up his sleeves and made a stop at the Umar Boxing in Northwest Baltimore. Umar Boxing does a lot in the community to help kids stay out of trouble. Governor Hogan commended the program and continues to push leaders. He wants action in the fight against crime and directed a letter to Attorney General Brian Frosch, stating in part that far often violent offenders are receiving a slap on the wrist before being released to commit more violent offenses in the letter. Baltimore police and ATF make two arrests in connection to last month's shooting and attempted murder of Baltimore Police Sergeant Isaac Carrington, and in the process closed a series of other cases with those arrests. Garon Foster and Rashad Neesmith are each charged with multiple counts of attempted first and second degree murder, as well as robbery, assault, and gun charges. The investigation also led to the arrest of 17-year-old Christopher Santiago, who allegedly was involved in a string of recent murders, shootings, and carjackings alongside Foster. Six other cases were also solved, including a July 11th triple shooting on the Alameda. 20 people in Maryland have lung injuries linked to vaping. The Department of Health updated the number of cases Wednesday. Seven deaths and hundreds of illnesses have been reported across the U.S. The CDC activated Emergency Operations Center. New York and Michigan have also banned the sale of flavored e-cigarettes in response to the growing number of cases.
Well, a cool start tomorrow morning at the bus stop means a light sweatshirt may be needed before sunny skies take over for the afternoon. High temperatures also a nudge cooler as well, only in the lower 70s in most neighborhoods. So light layers to start, wall-to-wall sunshine in the afternoon. Below average, though, with a high about 74 degrees, 60s in the mountains, 60s also at the coastline. 7-day forecast shows that sunshine continuing into the weekend. But the heat, it returns just in time for the first official day of fall on Monday. Highs close to 90 degrees with a late day shower or thunderstorm.
Stick with us online at WMER2News.com for updates on top stories and breaking news. And for news and weather while you're on the go, download the WMER2 app in your app store. You can watch live radar and get breaking news sent straight to your phone. Thanks for watching. I'm Kelly Swoop.
This WMER2 News update is sponsored by Jones Junction.